So the cutter is here and the template is here. So this marker is moving on the template and you are going to get the cutting action of a smaller size here. If the ratio is different, then you will get much smaller cutting out here compared to what is done here. So depending on the application, this can be used. Basically, it is kind of a magnifier or reducer for doing some cutting action. Okay, so that is called a pentograph. The mechanism looks like this. Then there is a parallelogram mechanism. Parallelogram mechanism. Now it is like this. One is same as three and one is fixed. So now here what happens is this link number three will move parallel to link number one all the time. So when you move like this, it will move parallel. Even this will also, both of them, two and four, they will move parallel. Now this fact is made use of for preparing a drafting machine. So for drafting machine, they are using this method where same arrangement is made. I'll just draw that again. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. Same parallelogram mechanism. Then what they do is they modify this link number 3. And this is converted into a disc. This 3 is converted into a disc so that you can fit 2 more links. So again, so 1, 2, 3 and 4, the one mechanism, and 3, 5, 6, 7 is another 4-bar mechanism fitted on the first mechanism. So 3 is common. So now what happens? This is another parallelogram mechanism. So now what happens, if you hold this particular link number 6 and move it anywhere, then it will continue to be like this wherever you take. It is all the time like this. So now what they do is, this link number 6 is modified to form a scale. So I'll draw here. I just shown something to represent a scale. So now this scale has one knob here. So you have to hold this knob and move this anywhere on the paper. You will find that this scale moves anywhere on the paper like this. That means if you want to draw a parallel line, so you draw a parallel line, one line here, and you take it here and draw another line. So these two lines will be parallel, because this doesn't rotate. As we have seen here, this link number 3 doesn't rotate, it will just move like, it will not do like this. It will move anywhere, if you take it will move like this. So here 1 is like this, so 3, this number 3, it will rotate like this, it will just move like this, it will not have any rotation. So because of that, 6 also will not have any rotation. So the scale also will not have any rotation. So it will just move anywhere on the paper, keeping this always horizontal and this vertical. So this is made use of for preparing a drawing. So this becomes a sketch of a mini drafter or a drafting machine. So the drafting machine is using the principle of parallelogram mechanism. Okay. Draw this, we'll take one more. Scissor mechanism. This is, again, you must have seen it somewhere. So as you know, this is a scissor. So when you press from here, the other end also moves. So this is made use of for forming a mechanism like this. There are joints at all these places. And then you can go on building it like this. You can see if you are seeing somewhere the collapsible door which is there. So that door also has got similar arrangement, only vertical it is. So here what happens is, suppose we fix it like this. And this end is working like a slider. So now what you will find is, this much part is a typical slider and crank mechanism which we have drawn earlier. This part is this. So only what they have done, this link number 2 is extended and link number 3 also is extended, and then another arrangement is made. So like that it is made. So now what happens, when you move it like this, when you slide this particular slider, then this entire mechanism gets shifted. So what they do here is, here they are fixing one platform. There is a platform here. So when you are moving it, very slight movement when you perform here. So when the slider is performing sliding motion like this, the platform is lifted up. So this scissor mechanism is used for the purpose. One of the applications is for working as a lifting platform. So when you want to lift some load, then the load is kept here. When you move this slider out, then this whole thing will collapse and this platform will come down and the load is at a lower level. So when you move this piston forward, that time the platform will raise up. Now this action can be carried out by some kind of a hydraulic cylinder or whatever is the actuating mechanism that can be fitted here so that the platform gets lifted. So this is one such example called as a scissor mechanism. So there are many such thousands of mechanisms are there. So just to give few examples, we have taken these three examples of scissor mechanism, parallelogram mechanism and pantograph. Okay, so you can learn them and then be able to write some short notes on that if they are asked in the exam and so on. So this is the principle on which it works.